When the Prophet ﷺ said, Almighty Allah loved those people, those who are soft-hearted. And the Jannah, paradise in the heavens, has been made forbidden for those people who are harsh-hearted. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud narrates from Holy Prophet, Hurrima al-Nari, kullu hayyinin, sahlin, qareebin min al-Nas. He said, the hellfire has been made forbidden for those who are mild and soft-mannered. They will never enter into the hellfire. They will never enter into hellfire. And those who are even-tempered person, and the people who is close to people, those who are very soft and kind, and people feel very themselves close to him. A person who is so beneficial to people, so openness, he possesses so openness of heart. He is so soft and kind and generous to people that people feel easy to work with them. People feel very happy to be with them, to sit in their company. So if you have such kind of soft heart and open breast and open behavior and kindness and mildness and softness and generosity and compassion and mercy in your personality, that people feel very happy and easy while they deal with you, while you sit in your company. Holy Prophet said, this kind of person will never allow to be entered into hellfire. Even if he committed some sins, Almighty Allah will forgive him. Even he committed some sins, because this act of softness, act of good moral behavior, act of kindness, act of generosity, act of benevolence, itself is a kafaratul zunub. It itself is repentance. Without asking for forgiveness by words, O Almighty God, please forgive my sins. Without performing this supplication formally, since you are doing good, and you are acting benevolently and generously, and you are doing kindly and softly with the people, your act of softness and kindness itself has become repentance of your sin for the life. Some people, a group of Jews came to Holy Prophet ﷺ, and they said some bad words. They prayed against the bad words which were praying against him. They said, death be on you, O Prophet Muhammad. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, his holy wife, was sitting next to him. She wanted to reply them in the same way. Holy Prophet ﷺ stopped her. As Aisha herself reports the hadith, he stopped her. She says, Ya Aisha, inna Allah rafiqun yuhibbur rifta fil amri kulli. O Aisha, be soft. Even in reacting, be soft. God is very gentle and kind and very soft. And he loves all those people who are gentle, kind and soft in everything, even to your enemies. In Holy Prophet is reported, this hadith is narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and it is reported by Imam Bukhari, Kitab al-Sahih. Holy Prophet ﷺ mentioned that there was a man in the old days, he was a merchant, and he used to give people credit, loans. When he saw someone in difficulty, he would say to his employees, he had appointed a secretary. And when that person died, Almighty Allah asked him, do you have any good deed which you may bring in front of me? He said, no, O God, I couldn't perform any good deed. Almighty Allah said, just remind, maybe you perform some good deed. It is in Sahih Bukhari. He said, I couldn't perform any good deed. Almighty God said, no, Joe, I give you more time. Just think about your life. Maybe you perform some good deeds. He said, I haven't performed any good deed except that I used to give the loans and credits to other needy people, and I have a young servant, my secretary, and I used to, after loaning the money to people, I used to send him to collect the money from them, he said. And I would say to him at the time when I used to send him to collect the money, I would say to him that take that which is easy for them to give back and leave that which is difficult for them to pay. And overlook them. Maybe if we overlook them, maybe God overlooks our faults. He said, this is the only act which I can think if it can be considered as an act of piety in my life. Nothing else. Almighty Allah called the angels of heavens. He said, take him and send him to the heavens, paradise. Because if he overlooked the faults of other, I am God, I have overlooked his faults. I have forgiven him. So this is the basic Islamic character. This is Islam and this is Iman and this is Ihsan. This is how God and Holy Prophet wants us to be and to behave in human society and to deal with other people.